Following a developing story out of Parkland, where the SWAT team was called to the home of school shooting survivor and activist David Hogg, and an apparent swatting incident. That's when a false report is made to police and the SWAT team is called out. CBS 4's Joan Murray is live in Parkland with the latest. Joan?
And Elliot, that incident caused a huge commotion in this community for a couple hours this morning, and schools in the area had to be put on lockdown after a 911 call came in that there was possible violence going in, but it all turned out to be a hoax. A Broward Sheriff's chopper circles over Heron Bay, SWAT saturing one of the subdivisions. They were responding to an emergency call that someone was barricaded in a home and a possible stabbing had happened. Schools in the area were put on lockdown, but it turns out it was all a hoax at the home of David Hogg, the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas student who has been outspoken on gun violence and the NRA. A deputy calmed neighbors' fears.
It wasn't true. It was a SWAT incident.
We talked to Hogg over the phone. He is in Washington, D.C., where he is getting the Robert F. Kennedy Human Rights Award.
This is a serious attempt at people trying to distract us from what we're trying to do here, which is solve the gun violence epidemic by getting youth out to vote and just getting morally just leaders elected, not Democrats, not Republicans, but actual Americans and morally just people that will work to solve this issue when our current politicians haven't. And that's all this is. It's a silly prank that's an attempted distraction from what we're trying to do here, and that's save children's lives.
Do you have any thought on who may have done that?
No clue. Nobody was home.
Nobody was home. Broward Sheriff's Office is investigating who made that prank phone call. As for Hogg, after he gets this award, he says he's going to be continuing his March for Our Lives movement work and plans to be in Chicago later this month for a big get out the vote effort. In Parkland at this noon, Joan Murray, CBS 4 News.